Welcome to one of Art's favorite watering holes, McKenna's on the Bay. We've got the owner, Nick Limer, here. Let's give him a round of applause for a great facility. Thank you, Nick. I'm Braden Phillips, and Art coerced me into emceeing this event tonight. And the way he did that was he threatened to force me to go over to his house and sit down and watch his entire video collection of the previous 499 shows. It should be. And frankly, I would do anything than have to watch those shows. So, I'm your MC for tonight. There are a lot of important people here, and most of you know who you are. The really important ones are sitting with Art by his choice, and they will be introduced when they get up to speak. Thank you all for taking time out of your busy schedules to help Art fulfill his dream that he actually has people who like him. And I am pleased to say that there are enough of you here to ensure that his inherent insecurities should be kept in check for about 2 weeks. Now, Art, as most of you know, has a genetic predisposition toward frugality. So predictably, he wants each of you to contribute as much as possible to make this night a success for him. Here are some options for your consideration. If you notice that Art's wine glass appears to be approaching empty, please feel free to offer him a refill on your tab. Art would love to be in a carefully posed picture with each of you, perhaps in front of the colorful proclamations and citations that you may have seen at the entry door over there. There's one from Congressman Alan Lowenthal, one from Supervisor Don Kanabe, one from Mayor Bob Foster. He simply asks that you use your cell phone, which should have at least 8 megapixels, and email him a copy of the picture. Additionally, Art brought a few copies of the most recent issue of the Long Beach Business Journal, which has a 2 by 2.5 inch color. Is George Economides here? Okay. So anyway, there's a 2 by 2.5 inch color picture of Art below the fold, well below the fold, I might add. And it refers to a story about his 500th episode on page 11, which is pretty close to the back of the front section. He'll be happy to sign either the picture or the article, or for special friends, and he assured me that you are all special friends, he'll sign both and even give you a free signed edition as a souvenir. That's just the kind of guy Art is. Now, I can see that some of you are already edging toward the exits back there, so before you go, let me tell you what you're going to miss. Art has created his own distinguished speaker series for tonight. And you'll be hearing some hopefully brief, let me reemphasize that for the table here in front, some hopefully brief remarks that from 10 other people that Art threatened with a video collection thing. Then before the highlight of the evening, we'll have to listen to Art. Whatever he's finished droning on, we'll finally get to watch a sneak preview of the 500th show. And I think, with the possible exception of Art's remarks, it'll be fun. So please stick around. So without further ado, let me introduce our first speaker, Mr. Del Heintz. For nearly 6 years, Del has been the California State Director of Government Relations for Charter Communications. His bio says he's responsible for 2 senators, 26 members of Congress, 56 members of the State Assembly and Senate, and over 125 communities throughout California. Sounds like a job Art would covet. In some ways, Dell and the company he represents are responsible for the longevity of straight talk and art's self-infatuation.
Forgive me, Father.
Yeah, you need to confess. Please welcome Dell Hynes to the microphone.
Well, that's a hard act to follow. It'll be in first is a blessing, or it's the
first opportunity for someone just to go down in flames. You know how that's like, don't you? No?
So, you know, we're the ones that actually have the pleasure to produce a show for art. And, you know, and 500 episodes is such a bellwether mark. And I've been able to come up with a couple statistics that kind of put it in perspective. By the way, Art, the first show you ever produced, was it black and white?
It was on radio.
It was on radio. I'm not saying that Art's tenured, okay? I'm not saying that Art's tenured, but I think it was pretty much black and white. And by the way, Ron Pickey is our producer-director.
Now, they would have communications back and forth in the control room to, you know, his desk.
And by the way, not saying that Art was cheap, but tin cans and string? Come on! Tin cans and string. In fact, Art was so cheap, all he afforded was a string at the first part of his career. In fact, Art's first show and his tenure is so ancient, it was on radio. I think you already beat me to that punch. You sold my line.
Sorry about that.
But, you know, it's all about aspirations, right, Art? It's all about aspirations. Let me just kind of give you some aspirations. All right, I did some research on TV shows, all right? Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood, 895 episodes. You've got a little more to go, buddy, but you look good in a cardigan sweater, right? All right. Wheel of Fortune, Art, 5,030 shows. Do you think you can last another 50 years to meet 5,030 shows?
Anything for Vanna.
All right, anything for Vanna. Late Night with David Letterman, 1,810 shows. I think you have him shaken in his boots, Art. Okay? In fact, I think he's going to put you on the top 10 shows of best shows to watch on radio. Oh, that's an old line. It's just not working.
I got a laugh.
I know. There's an old adage, be first or last. Okay, Saturday Night Live. I think Art should host one, don't you? You know, for those of you who have been on Art's show, it's a 60-minute, it's a 30-minute show, but it takes, what, 2 days? 2 days? My God, you know, it's just the tenure, Art. By the way, you do have some aspirations, Art. You know, so there are some shows that you've actually beat. I've Got a Secret. Who in the room remembers I've Got a Secret from the 50s, okay? They only had 350 episodes, okay? So, you know, you're beating that. Jack Benny, well, okay? Jack Benny only had 343 episodes. Bonanza. Who remembers Bonanza? You know, on color TV. Oh, God. You know, the gray-haired set. Bonanza only had 430 episodes. You know, I think Art looks good riding into the sunset on a rocking horse, don't you? All right. Ozzie and Harriet. We all remember Ozzie and Harriet. Oh, my gosh. No, did anybody ever see Ozzie go to work? Has anybody ever seen Art go to work? You have? Are you writing his checks? Well, and the most important milestone is SpongeBob SquarePants only has 230 episodes and you got him beat. Congratulations.
Thank you.
But seriously, we've had the pleasure of being the distributor of his art, his talent, his wisdom, and his knowledge for many, many years. And in my business and in politics, it's all about local. And Art, what you've done for our company, for Charter Communications, by allowing us to be able to take your wisdom and your knowledge and the people you interview and put them across the entire Southern California market, has been very beneficial to my company. We are extremely grateful, and we look forward to another 500, buddy. Thank you.
Thank you, Dell. Next up is a man who was there at the beginning with Chris Pook and others, the president of the Long Beach Grand Prix Association, Mr. Jim McCallion. For years, Art has been pestering him about and pestering Jim about why Art has never been asked to participate in the Celebrity Pro-Am event. Has anybody else in the room ever seen Art dance? Well, anybody who's observed his seemingly disjointed and arrhythmic efforts at dancing fully understand why you, Jim, have never let him drive a car. And we thank you for your outstanding judgment. Please welcome Jim to the microphone.
Thank you very much, and I have to remark just before I get started, is this a beautiful evening or what? I mean, this is sort of what we all live around Long Beach and North Orange County and the area for. It's just absolutely gorgeous, and great view for all of your patrons too, John.
This good is, therapy. This
is, exactly, it's fantastic. Well, I'm delighted to come and say a few words about my friend Art. You know, Art talks about 500 shows. I sort of measure Art's existence and his involvement with Straight Talk in terms of where he's conducted these events. For those of you who sort of been around for a while, we started back, I remember the first show I was on many, many years ago was over on Redondo, and then we moved from Redondo over to the Lakewood substation, remember, over by the Sheriff substation. Then we came back and we were in Santa Fe over on Roscoe. And now we're over at Cal State Long Beach. So you can sort of measure the transition of Art's Straight Talk show more by the location than almost anything else. But it's been sort of a fun time. I've had the privilege of being on any number of times. And it is true that Art has been bugging me for many years about being in the Toyota Pro Celebrity race. And I always have asked Art, if you want to be in the pro celebrity race, you have to be obviously a pro or celebrity. and as was just observed, he certainly isn't a pro, and I guess he didn't quite make the definition of what we use as a qualification for being a celebrity. So, unfortunately, to this date, Art, you haven't yet qualified for either one of those, but the challenge remains, and we'll see if your celebrity will reach the qualification status. So for Art, you really have had the opportunity, though, to do a real public service in terms of the information that has been disseminated through his shows. I've always enjoyed coming on because Art has a way of conducting his interviews. For those of you who've had the opportunity to be on there, this event started pretty much on time. For those of you who know about Art's operation, we always used to have to go in and do the whole makeup thing and discuss what we're going to discuss when we're about to discuss it. And so actually tonight is sort of neat. We don't have to go through makeup, and we haven't had to go through any of that, and that's it. And that's the reason why we're going to get out of here on time tonight too, right? So, but thank you very much for what you've done for the community. I think the expansion into all of your, what is it now, 40, 50, 60 different cities around is indicative of the desire of people to see what it is that you're disseminating through your shows and to provide information that obviously is relevant to everybody. So thanks again, Art. Thank you for what you've done for the community, for your public service, and for your contribution so far. And let's go for another 500. Thank you.
Thanks, Jim. The Wet Wednesday crowd's coming in, Art. They'll be here in just a minute.